Hello friends, today we are going to solve the numerical which are based on chemical kinetics. The numerical is at a certain temperature the half changes times for catalytic decomposition of ammonia are given below, and in this case the pressure and given half is given. The pressure for this decomposition of ammonia is 50. For the 50 pressure given half is 3.52. For pressure 100, T1 half is 1.82, and for pressure 200, the T1 half is 0.93. So, friend, in this case, we want to find out order of the reaction. Then you just find out order of reaction. Friends, such a type of the numerical can ask in competitive exam like NET, SET, GATE, SLET, etc. And there is this one numerical is based on tricks. Okay, therefore we should be understand which type of the relationship is developed or given in this numerical. Now look toward this, the pressure is double and T1 half is half. Same here, pressure is double and T1 half means half life period for half. Means what is the relation? So friends, before going to take the first order reaction rate constant equation and second order reaction rate constant equation and third order and then substitute and find out the rate constant, that is not possible for us. Therefore, we should be understand what is the relation between half-life period and the given initial pressure or the given pressure. Okay. So friends, if you remember that in theory lecture, I was already told to you that the T1 half is inversely proportional to A raised to N minus 1. Then this is the relationship related to the initial concentration of the chemical reaction, or this is the relationship of the given pressure. Okay. So friends, if you understand this one, you are realized the answer of this reaction. Suppose T1 half is directly proportional to the initial concentration in case of zero order reaction. Okay, T1 half is inversely proportional to this is in first order reaction. This equation is indicated that the first order reaction cannot dependent of, means the half-life period of first order reaction cannot be dependent on the initial concentration or initial pressure of the reaction. In another case, T1 half is inversely proportional to the initial concentration of the given reaction or initial pressure of the given reaction, and this case we have to find for the second order reaction. Same thing, T1 half is inversely proportional to the square of initial concentration and square of initial concentration of the pressure. Of course, this case for the third order reaction. So friends, on this basis it clearly indicates that the half-life period is increases, the T1 half is decreases, and this relationship we have to find out in the given equation, and on that basis we will be concluded that the given numerical is nothing but the second order reaction numerical. Means what? Decomposition of ammonia is a second order reaction. Friends, when such a type of the numerical is come in front of you, you just look toward the data regarding to the pressure or regarding to the concentration. What is the relationship is developed here? If we increase the pressure, whether the half-life period is increases, whether the half-life period is decreases, and which type of this sequence will be observed in the half-life period, you should be noticed that. And if you understand the given data or given solution, it's clearly, it's very helpful to you. It's only one of the example of the second order reaction, and we are concluded the given numerical is second order reaction. But friend, if you understand the relationship between T1 half and initial concentration, if you observe the data, you are able to find out whether the reaction is zero order reaction, whether the reaction is third order reaction or first order reaction. So friend, we will be discuss or take the next numerical on the same topic.